slow tide of purple shadows fans out from it. The dark hills in the distance, urged on by cool evening breeze, it spreads across the rolling desert floor, a sinister creep. And silently captures all the abandoned roads that crisscross a few clumps of greasewood and ocotillo in the area. It sneaks up the winding, unused path and caresses the bottom edge of a beat-up screen door, which swings on its rusty hinge as if trying desperately to escape. Then it spills over the ragged planks and onto the dull leather of my shoe. And I'm staring into the setting sun, wearing someone else's suit, propped up in a faded, dusty chair, with my wooden grin. I'm a mannequin, just east of Ground Zero in dreamland. Lopsided buildings huddled together as if for protection in the growing pool of darkness. Inside, the last traces of daylight evaporate from torn lampshades and shabby furniture, drifting out through broken windows and missing doors, mingling with the breeze. And then the sky itself begins to fade away, and the earth turns upside down and falls headlong into an infinite sea of stars. Invisible in our darkened rooms, counting the hours and the years, never moving, not an inch, but faithfully holding all those phony poses, exactly as we found ourselves in awkward imitations of real life. And here we are, where our thoughts and our sleeves are disintegrating. Eternal vigilance is the price we pay to be the mannequins just east of ground zero in dreamland.